what is the marketing information. If my product is targeted to this stage group, in my marketing communication, I will highlight how we are contributing to
sales.
But then we need to know it. This is between females and males. So what I am trying to say is, based on what you are learning, look at doing some amount of understanding based on the target group which is already in our classes. I am already in talks with the company of 1 million. What does 1 million do? 1 million is the group or company which manages that program for all India. Where there is a card in which people can go and take to different outlets and they get preferential treatment. Now let's go to the next step. It is going to be on an app. So there is going to be a card. For example, I may even think that all students who have paid up to, let's say, a certain fee will get a card. As a gift from IC, please make it. And how am I going to connect it to the outlets? Who are the people? Students? A lot of brands want to connect to students. Right? So I'm talking to them. So this will come into some sections, you know, catches and aggregators. So the point that I'm trying to make is we must understand our people much better in order to sort of create more targeted marketing. So therefore the next session which I will give, first week of January, is on market research. But this will continue into market research. How we conduct research, what are the things that you should look at, get the trend. So please correct it. Now, typical planning input, this is on social media. This data, again from CII UK, it talks of social media sales only email use of. See, what is happening is, at times we believe a particular media is doing anything. But when you look at data correctly, you realize that certain things are not necessary. I'll give an example of ABPM data. We have a client called Sweden Telugu. Recently, we did a full page ad in Hindi and a full page ad in Telegram, Facebook. It cost them 25 lakhs. Okay? They got 17 responses from Telegram, 1 7, and they got 88 responses from Hindi. So, total they got around 105 messages. So, 25 lakhs. And 105 phone calls. So they are measuring it. Now when they are realizing, now what we are doing? We are experimenting with small components. Today, for example, in that one stop activity, there is a street ad. That costs 31,000. So we are seeing, again, the street ad, even if I get 40 calls, it is more costly. So this is a continuous process. So for example, here they are saying Facebook, 7 in 10,000 data engagement with the Facebook post among brand fans. 3 in 10,000 is Twitter, 1% is e-commerce sales, 17% of it provided by email. So through email 17% and 1% is through email. So what I am trying to say is we need to continuously evaluate. For example, if we believe that our future students' social media habit will be similar to what we have predominantly now, that's a fair hypothesis to make. So do we know the current social media behavior of the current students? How will we know it? Is it different in geography versus their developed? It could be. It could be. It could be different in Chicago. So one formula may not be as accurate. Do you understand? the market. Simple word of mouth could be one, evolving social platforms. Abundance of choice, what does it mean? If the customer has many options to make, then the influencer is more advanced. Upcoming options. See the example. Immediate launching of iPhone 7 will hold up the issue of some guys. Better. Like, I know for sure you will be done that before one tell us the response. Competitors like this. Jio has taken the win out of all the other mobile operators. This is market influence. Anything else, an organization needs to work on market influences specific to their products, which can accelerate by induction, which is called a catalyst, or integrate their products with other buying industries, which is called an activator. We'll talk about this and we'll go along. Yes. So let's look at what are aggregators and catalysts. Aggregators are catalysts that predominantly present in many market environments in the world, owing to the fact that consumers have choice to explore much more through social networks and internet use these days, as opposed to word of mouth recommendation and endorsement from celebrities. Again, okay, celebrities in. So, for example, let me give an example. You will typically see in airline there are summer packages, summer packages. If you take a buy a ticket in JNS and you go to Kerala, there is a tie up with some hotel, there is a tie up with local cab. So, what are you doing? You are aggregating on one platform which is going to help the buying behavior of the customer. Are you getting my point? So, is there anything that we can look at where we also sort of work with other brands and aggregate? I don't know. So, that's what we will do.
Yeah.
this Bermudian also talking, Bermudian is the platform that they are aggregating multiple retail brands into one card.
That is the Bermudian.
That is one form of aggregation. But what they are talking of aggregation is this general target access card, where three related services are coming together and being bundled to a customer in order to influence buying. For example, we may say that Big Bazaar is not to interest. We say that all ladies students who buy Big Bazaar garments for winter of this much amount and more will get 10,000 rupees off on our ICS credits. Really? Good? So, example, the smartphone appliance controller Hive provides opportunity to many other companies such as British Gas, Apple, Samsung, who can integrate with these products and take advantage to grow them. So, that's the platform on the Catalyst. In line of the above, other Apple companies can ride on the vendors and demand created in the market for app-based smartphone appliance control products. For example, I just mentioned to you that Bermudian has got a lot of retailers who are part of it. Can we take Bermudian cell and tell them that the ICA has students who are your primary category? So if, let's say, coffee coffee day for any Bermudian cartoon gives 10% off, because the target students only to ICA, can you give 15% off? Are you getting my point? So that Bermudian card on which on one hand there is retailer and here is my student, so we are connecting both of them to create a special offer. Which means those retailers through Bermudian card is reaching out to my customers who are students, and we are also benefiting because my customers are getting additional benefit from the same retailer by using the same Bermudian card. That's a right person. So this is what I am trying to say, and see here a case study is recommended that will help you develop that online cost of the information from the customer. So you people must think of how can we use aggregator and catalyst for concepts for IT. This is a team case. Are you getting my point? As a concept, how do we utilize this for our IT? Let me give you a few thoughts. There are two ways of looking at it. One is, what benefit can I give my students with other partners, through other partners, so that my skills become a brand journalist. Okay? That is one way of looking at it. Another way of looking at it, what benefit can I give to customers of other related brands so they are motivated to buy it? That's the other. Are you getting my point? So let's do a question here. Now see this last example, fantastic. Brexit is acting as a catalyst for growth in businesses of UK bound products and services because of the drop in the value of pound. Because of Brexit, the value of pound has gone down. A lot of people are actually trying to do business in UK now. So the Brexit has become a catalyst for growth of business in UK because pound has got devalued. Catalyst. Clear? Alright. Now this is a very important slide that I look at analysis. This slide is all about effectiveness of the influencers. We know that influencers play a very important role in our business. Right? sometimes what she is saying is, let's say there are different types of influencers who are there. Who is more effective?
Master of the teacher, mother.
So, how does she look at it? If you look at what are the one good thing, if you see the chart and I contextualize it to it. This blue chart is influencer and bottom chart is recommendations. Okay? In this study, in a McKinsey study, in this first impact ratio, 5% is giving 15% recommendations. So the impact ratio is 3 times. Right? In the second one, 10% is giving 24% recommendations, around 2.5 times. In the third one, is 20% is giving 40%, which is twice. Okay? Now, let's put this on IC platform. Imagine the first set of influencers is students. Current students, how many recommendations are they giving? What is the education? Second one, let's say is tutorial rooms. What is the recommendation percentage? Third one, let's say is college students. So what happens is, if we can do this analysis, we know that which influencer is a bigger leverage for us, and therefore we can spend it. Are you understanding? We are doing all this, but this is where the science comes. We can channelize our efforts, we can channelize our incentives, a lot of things we can do.
We are giving our effective business, so we can give some more things.
The ratio, where do I go? Let's say it's a college seminar. Is an influencer? What, how many recommendations is it generating? You should look at it. Because that's why we spend a lot of efforts and money. Versus what activity? What is it giving? Scholarship is that. What is it giving?
But even some other hand, suppose it's college activity, so college seminar. Don't you think that it can give us in some other way, like, you know, when something is hammering in their mind, they are seeing this thing in the college, then you can be able to make institutions in the teacher. But actually, your teacher is the one that the student came and asked.
Right.
So, that is not percentage, if they are very minimum percentage, maybe, but he got influenced a bit from college manager.
Good point. Now, look at your analogy. Similar annual analysis. You can advertise in television. You can advertise in print, you can advertise in radio, you can advertise in outdoor. When a student comes, he says this way also, right? But then, what do we do typically? We look at where did he see, say he has seen us from, and we get to be more money in that video. So, it gets impacted everywhere, but what it is saying is, how do you optimize your effort? How do you optimize your incentive? How do you optimize your marketing plan? That is what it is. That's what everything we have now in there. But if you have 100 rupees, which is your power, you have 100 rupees. That is what I'm saying. It is not that you want to do that at all. But you may reduce this and increase. That is the point that we are trying to make. Okay, I mean, so why I said this is very, very important for us. Alright, in the buying journey, after this slide, we can break buttons and then we'll have next. There are 5 steps. First is awareness. First is aware of our brand. Second is consideration. We are aware of so many brands. But do we check out every brand?
No.
So this awareness and consideration is when we are playing all this role of seminars, tutorials, etc. There are people who will be aware of our state. Suddenly start considering it. Now the problem here is there is a lot of social media, internet search, Google search, which influences these two stages of buying process. You agree? Today, if you want to buy anything, you will buy everything.
Yes.
Now, after this tool, the customer is convinced to purchase. Now, this model is more for our product listing. But once the buyer has purchased this thing, we have purchased a brand of TV, Goodrick. Whether I will repurchase that part is the intention. I have bought a brand of Useful T-shirt. Next time when I wear buy a T-shirt, am I buying Useful or am I going to something else? So what all do I do in terms of retaining the customer? Now for us, fortunately when the customer comes in, he is there with us for some time. Am I right? Unlike the product category where he is there only during the time of purchase. After that he may come much later, like Puja. Somebody may buy new clothes, so maybe he puts it next Puja, again 1 year back, next Puja. So in between, what do I do so the next time comes to me? For us, this becomes very important. Because we have learned that my current student will only help me to get the future student. 1:3, one is to 5 question. I'll tell you what. 1:10, if you have practiced that, 5, you will get that people. So, what I have always been telling you since in the recent and recent thing I have said that we purchase from the student enterprise and then we hand it over to the quality. But they are ultimately not accountable for sales.
But last year you told me that there should be accountable for that is aligned.
That's what I can make.
Yes.
So the student entire journey in ICA should be monitored and managed by the sales team. Then only we can create advocacy. If we find that there is a certain amount of discontent, maybe the student is unhappy with the way fundamental accounts is done. Now that doesn't mean not even. But if my understanding, my center manager is very tuned with the student who comes and says, this class is getting boring, can you do something about it? Then we can come through the faculty and the Anupriya team group to ensure that it becomes more. So that is where we have to work on. For creating advocacy. This part in ICA actually belongs to human value. So that the person doesn't drop out in the middle of the bush. Otherwise, we have not got the money. We feel like we have booked whatever, 40,000, 60,000, whatever is the course fee. But what is my net realization?
And that is for 1:-10. If it is not there, that is for
1:10. Okay? So we will go into the next one after a period. So far, any questions?
No.
Very relevantly, are you?
Yes.
Now we are getting into operation rules of this.
Yes.
So now we will combine these classes. Then look at the logistics and the project which we are doing for January March 12. That's a good project which will submit to Cambridge for evaluation and their comments.
Okay.
So imagine that you can get comments from there that is why they say, they tell you what you have done right, what you could have done better.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's okay. Yeah, and that is something which we use anyway for our
digital policy approach.
But turn off this quite often, we take a picture of this camera.